Welcome, explorers. I'm Joe Acaba, astronaut and current chief of NASA's astronaut office. But before I became an astronaut, I was a math and science teacher. Now I use my passion for teaching to teach astronauts. And here's the secret. They're just like you. They learn and discover every day. NASA is returning to the moon with our new mission called Artemis. And you are part of the Artemis generation, and we need you for this very important mission. Are you ready? In a few minutes, you will be stepping into the roles of NASA experts and learning what it takes to make lunar exploration possible with our new education content from Next Gen STEM called NASA's Exploration Experience. Like real NASA experts, we want you to be problem solvers, explore the knowns and unknowns, generate possible solutions, consider pros and cons of each solution, determine the best path forward, and finally, present your findings to your team. Remember, be creative and curious, ask questions, test and retest, and most importantly, work as a team because we are better together. I can't wait to see what you, the Artemis generation, can do. Let's go, explorers.
Hey, team members, Explorer Josh here with your mission briefing and assignment. Please have your mission information in front of you as you prepare for your assignment. The focus is on the spacesuit gloves going to the moon. Here is your mission background.
NASA's Artemis missions will bring astronauts back to the moon for the first time since the Apollo era.
Tranquility Base here. The Eagle has landed.
The missions build on more than 50 years of space exploration experience, using new, innovative technologies to explore more of the lunar surface than ever before. It's important that Artemis astronauts have a spacesuit that is up for the task. Spacesuits need to be able to protect astronauts from extreme temperatures and pressures, provide them with critical life support, and be functional to wear and work in. The gloves of spacesuits require particular attention, as astronauts need to use their hands and bend their fingers to complete tasks, like collecting lunar samples.
I recently went to Johnson Space Center in Houston, Texas, to meet an expert who can help you succeed on your mission.
Christine Davis is an engineer who specializes in spacesuits.
What do you as a spacesuit engineer do every day?
A spacesuit engineer gets to work on spacesuits. So spacesuits are small human-sized spacecrafts. So I get to help design, build, and test spacesuits. Inside the suit, we want to provide oxygen, we want to provide air pressure to be able to keep them in a stable environment. And then outside the suit, we want to think about what environment they're going into. Lunar dust is really sharp and it's really abrasive, so we want to make sure that our suit is safe against that. And then also, what kind of tasks will they be doing? Will they be building a habitat? Will they be deploying a satellite? Will they be fixing something that's broken?
Christine is part of a large team working together to make sure Artemis astronauts are comfortable, safe, and able to do their jobs. Now comes the fun part. Here is your mission assignment.
Working together, you and a test facilitator will need to complete as many wing nut, washers, and bolt assemblies as you can with your bare hands within a specific time limit. You will then put on multiple layers of gloves to approximate the protective and comfort elements built into spacesuit gloves. With your hands now fully protected, you'll repeat the task, again completing as many assemblies as you can within the same time limit. The test facilitator will track the time and the number of completed assemblies.
To increase your chances of success, Christine has some guidance and advice on how to do your job.
Sometimes fast isn't the key. Slow and steady is much better. So we want people to be slow and deliberate whenever they're doing glove tasks. So sometimes going faster, you might make mistakes because, again, you don't have that tactility. So just slow and steady wins the race.
Once you've completed the mission two times, switch roles so the test facilitator becomes the engineer and vice versa.
As an engineer, I wish you the best of luck with your mission. You got this.
Please check in with your mission director to ensure all safety guidelines are followed and to determine what group sharing will happen at the end of the event. Good luck. You've got this.